Hi, Shotgun is here, camera OP and colorist, the founder of Shade & Grain. Welcome to another episode of the Basic of Color Theory, Keynowledge. This section is dedicated to what is Rec.709. This means that what you see is what you get. Here is the color spectrum that human eye can see. Our eyes do not perceive anything beyond that. As you can see, the visible light spectrum comprises an electromagnetic wavelength of about 380-740 nanometers. The photoreceptor cells in the human eye, the rods and cones, respond to light waves in this area, which is a visual processing system in brain converted into a perception of light and colors. In 1921, scientists William David Wright and John Gould conducted a series of experiments to quantify the human perception of colors. These experiments laid the foundation of the development of the first RGB color space, the red, green, and blue, a mathematical domain whose boundaries are defined by the three pure wavelengths of the primary color space wavelength. Monochromic could be a better word to define these three pure wavelengths. In 1931, CIE, or International Commission of Lighting, continues this research, and the result was a mathematical system of the quantifying all colors can perceive by the human eye. This color is also called horseshoe, as you can see. By definition, color gamut is the range of the color within the visible color space that the devices such as monitor or projector can reproduce. You can think of the color gamut as color palette you can choose from when creating an image. The wider the color palette, the richer the image you can create, and vice versa. Color gamut acts as a language to define colors. Of course, as with languages, there is many different types. The inshore and industry players use the same language to define colors. Industry groups such as International Telecommunication Union, Radio Communication Sector, or ITUR periodically establish a specific color palette for by using their peers. Rec.709 is one of the main standards for the color gamut. Rec.709 was published in 1990 with a color scale that served to define the colors for not dominance high definition television market. Today, Rec.709 is the basis of the color science in our displays, including TVs, monitors, smartphones, etc. But here's a trick. Rec.709 is a standard for monitors, not cameras, although in practice, maybe more or less equivalent. A 709 camera designed to drive the 709 displays. This means that a camera outputs a signal in which number of the real photons hitting the sensor is encoded, so that it looks reasonable when the display decoded back into the photons. The relationship between the encoding numbers and the amounts of the lights coming out of the display is not straightforward for complicated historical reasons, but it is not correct. The image will look too contrasty, too flat, too dark, or too bright. The basic procedure of the combining red, green, and blue to create a color image is quite simple. 709, for example, is notorious for its faint green because the green dye defined in a standard is quite pale and unsaturated. Take a look again on a CIE horseshoe. 709 cannot display a green deeper than the 0.3. 0.6 on the CIE 1931 diagram. 709 should ensure that different cameras produce a similarly bright rendering of the equally bright real-world objects. However, it's a fact that many manufacturers currently playing with the rules at least a little bit in order to achieve the more aesthetically pleasing attractive images. In a more modern context, it would be completely unacceptable to directly enforce the limits of these standards. There is nothing technically stopping anyone to reduce the dynamic range of much higher dynamic range picture to the point where it looks good on a conventional monitor. Here a dynamic range is a contrast, and we will discuss it in the next video. So what was the Keynowledge of the Rec.709? For knowing more information and details, including the camera setting and how to work with Rec.709, click on this video, ring the bell, press the thumb, and feel free to write me a comment. Shotgun is here, founder of the Shade & Grain. Enjoy the color.